So, good morning all of you. Yesterday we had studied the third chapter, fiber to fabric. Okay, so just before starting, just let me summarize. Today we are going to discuss the question and answers, but before starting that, let me just summarize lesson number 3, fiber to fabric. So just let us see the summary of this chapter. In the beginning of this chapter, we had studied, okay, how the animal fibers, wool and silk especially, we are using, correct? So mainly we discussed about wool. Then we discussed that wool is derived from the hairy fibers of the sheep. Usually we call it as the fleece. Okay, then we studied that the process of selective breeding. So we discussed that the process of selecting parents for obtaining special characters in the offspring. So such a thing, it is called as selective breeding. Okay, now there are different animals that are yielding wool. Okay, for example, yak. We know sheep already. Yak is there. Okay, it is common in Tibet and Ladakh. Then angora wool is there. It is obtained from angora goats. Then there is under fur of Kashmiri goat. Okay, it is woven into fine shawls, which is called as the pashmina shawls. Further, in South America, we find different kind of fur growing organisms like llama, alpaca, etc. Okay, such organisms are also grown to yield wool. Besides this, fewer animals which are common to us, they are also grown, okay, like rabbit and all, but we cannot obtain large amount of hair from them. Okay, now next we studied about processing of fibers to wool, how fibers are processed into wool. Okay, so there are 6 steps for processing the fiber to wool. The first step we call it as shearing. Okay, in shearing, what do we do is, we usually remove the hair of the sheep, usually in the hot weather. Okay, so this will enable the sheep to survive without their protective coat of hair. And they do not need this. Okay, in the second step, what is done? The sheared skin, it is thoroughly washed in tanks. And the grease, dirt, dust, all these are removed. This method we call it as scoring. Nowadays it is done by machines. In the third step, sorting is done, that is separation of the of these fleece it is done. In the fourth step, burrs are removed. In the fifth step, the fibers are dyed, and in the sixth step, the fibers are straightened, combed and rolled and made into yarn. These are the 6 steps. Okay, then we had studied about the life history of the silk moth. Okay, we had studied that the adult male and the female, okay, they give rise to a large number of eggs. These eggs grow on the mulberry trees. The eggs grow and develop into silkworms. Okay, silkworm is also known as a larva. We can call it as a caterpillar also. Okay, so this, after some days, it turns and it spins a silk like structure around itself. This is called as the cocoon. We can also known it as the pupal stage or the pupa. Okay, so this cocoon, what is done, it stays inside this silky structure, and then what is done, we obtain this for getting the silk yarn or the silk thread. Okay, so rearing silk and processing silk is associated with the pupal stage. Okay, so in the case of silkworms, a female silk moth, it lays a large number of eggs. So these eggs, what is done, it is carefully stored, and they are allowed to grow on the mulberry leaf. Okay, and then what is done, the larva grows out of them. So the caterpillar's duty is to eat day and night, and their size increases. Okay, then what is done, the larva, they are allowed to grow after 25 to 30 days, they will stop eating and they will start spinning cocoons around themselves. Okay. So once these cocoons are obtained, then what is done? The cocoon is either dried in the sun or it is warm. Okay, or it is put in boiling water and the worm inside is killed and we take the silk from that. Huh? Now processing of silk occurs here. So here what is done? Once the silk fiber is obtained, then the reeling, the process of taking out the threads from the cocoon for use as silk, we call it as reeling. Okay, reeling starts and reeling is done in special machines. Okay, and fibers of silk are spun and silk fibers are processed to get silk threads. Okay, they are woven into silk cloth by the weavers. Okay, let us see the next slide now. See on the next slide. In your textbook, okay, if you see page number 32, look at the first question. You must be familiar with the following nursery rhymes. Ba ba black sheep, have you any wool? Mary had a little lamb whose fleece was white as snow. So these were the two rhymes, nursery rhymes. So considering this, you have to answer the following. Which parts of the black sheep have wool? And what is mean by the white fleece of the lamb? So, the hairy skin called fleece has wool in black sheep. So, fleece is the hairy part, okay, which has got wool in the black sheep. And white fleece of the lamb means white colored hairy skin. Question number 2. The silkworm is a caterpillar or a larva? You have to choose the correct option. So what is a caterpillar? Silkworm. The silkworm is both a caterpillar and a larva because caterpillar is the larval stage. Question number 3. Which of the following does not yield wool? Yak, camel, goat, woolly dog. So we have not heard about woolly dog, right? So that will be our answer. Woolly dog. They do not have much hair. Okay. We can't share them. Then next. Question number 4. What is mean by the following terms? Rearing, shearing, sericulture. Answer you can see on the screen. Rearing is the process of keeping, feeding, breeding and medical care of useful animals. Okay. These animals produce one or more useful products for human beings. So HTI, that is a typing mistake. HU it should be. Human beings. Shearing. Shearing is the process of removing the fleece of the sheep along with thin layer of skin. Sericulture. Sericulture is the rearing of silkworms for obtaining silk. Question number 5. Given below is a sequence of steps in the processing of wool. Which are the missing steps? You have to add them. After shearing, we have studied step 1 to 6 for processing of wool. Step 1, shearing. Step 2 is scouring. Step 3 is sorting. Step 4 is picking out of burrs. Step 5 is coloring. Step 6 is rolling. One line is missing in the question, but still you can understand. So you can say rolling or convert it into yarn. Then you can see the 6th question on the screen. Make sketches of the 2 stages in the life history of a silk moth which are directly related to the production of silk. Okay. So you can see in your textbook. You can see the figures. Okay. Figure 3.9 in your textbook can be used. Or the same figure you can draw which I have drawn on this, or I have placed on this slide. Any which is comfortable to you, you can use them. Either the figure 3.9 of your textbook or the figure 16.13 which has been shown on the slide over here. Okay, which is comfortable to you, you can use. So this is the process related to how the silkworm is converted to food. Question number 7. Out of the following, which are the two terms related to silk production? So you can easily understand. It is sericulture and moriculture. Okay. Silk production involves cultivation of mulberry leaves and rearing of silkworms. And second one is scientific name of mulberry is Morus albus. So moriculture is the cultivating of mulberry trees, and sericulture is the cultivation or the growing of silkworms for getting silk. Okay. Whereas floriculture is growing of flowers, then apiculture is growing of honeybees, and silviculture is cultivation of forests. Okay. So as you can see, match the words of column with those column 2. Okay. So scoring is cleaning of sheared skin. Mulberry leaves is the food of the silkworm. Yak is a wool yielding animal, and cocoon yields silk fiber. Reeling here, no option is there. Okay, no question is there, so it's lying as it is. Okay, so you can see scoring is cleaning sheared skin, mulberry leaves food of silkworm, yak wool yielding animals, cocoon yields silk fiber. Okay, so next, if the ninth question, okay, you have to there's a crossword puzzle based on this lesson. You have to use the hints to fill in the blank spaces with the letters. Answer for this has been provided. Now these are some extra questions which you can see on the screen. You have to write this extra questions also. Okay, question number 1, name the source of obtaining fibers. So the answer is sources of obtaining fiber are plants and animals. Question number 2, name some wool yielding animals. Wool yielding animals are sheep, yak, llama, alpaca, angora goat, angora rabbit and camel. Question number 3, how do the hair of certain animals help in keeping their bodies warm? Hair traps a lot of air which is a poor conductor of heat, resulting their body next. You can see the fourth question. Name the goats which are found in Tibet and Ladakh region. Tibet and Ladakh Angora goats are found. Question number 5. In which part the wool yielding animals llama and alpaca are found? Llama and alpaca are found in South America. Question number 6. Name the process of taking out silk fibers from the cocoon for use as silk. The process of taking out threads from the cocoons for use as silk is called reeling the silk. Question number 7. Which stage in the life cycle of silk moth is called cocoon? Answer is the covering of silk fibers inside which the caterpillar covers itself is called as a cocoon. So these are the extra questions. 7 extra questions are there. I expect all of you to write these extra questions also in your science notebook. And I will be sending these question answers in the PDF format. I hope you will be completing your notes. Okay. And after you complete your notes, please send a photo of your notebook to me for correction. Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you.